Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm reviving my old whiteboard and I'm going to show you how to read notes on the violin. First of all, how can we identify that we are dealing with violin notes or sheet music, as you say in English? And for that, there is the so-called treble clef, or also called violin clef, which is this beautiful thing right here. This clef indicates to us that we have music written for violin. The form of this clef originates from the letter G, which is kind of hidden inside still. So you could say there is the letter G still hiding inside this violin clef. This would be the G, and this the continuation of the clef. This clef has the name G clef because here, where the point of the G is, there is the note G. So this is the meaning of the violin clef or the G clef, that we know that on the second line from the bottom there is the note G. To now be able to identify which note to play on the violin, we need to know the basic scale, which is the C major scale without any sharps or any flats. I'm going to show you why is that. But first, let's learn that scale. It's easy to remember on the piano, because the piano is basically built in a symmetrical way which fits the C major scale. And all other notes with sharps or with flats are in a different color than the natural notes from the C major scale. The C major scale notes are on the piano are the white keys, and the flats and sharps are usually the black keys. I was talking about symmetrical, but the piano keyboard is only symmetrical on a larger scale. What you can see is we have here two black keys together and here three black keys together. And I can tell you so much that this pattern continues on the piano. We have here two, then again three, and then again two, and so on. What is important now for us to identify is where lays the C major scale, where it begins. And I can tell you the C is always below this two black keys on the left side. So here we have the C. The importance of knowing the basic theory behind the scale is especially important for us on the violin, because our violin is not built in a symmetrical manner like the piano keyboard to the C major scale. So let's identify the factors which make this C major scale a C major scale. What you need to know is that the major and also the minor scale in the classical Western music consists of whole steps and half steps. A whole step is exactly the size as two half steps. So what we can see right here on the piano is that we have between some keys a black key. In that situation, the black key is the half step and the next white key is the whole step. And here again, we have a whole step, and between that there would be the black key, the half step. And then we have some situations where we don't have a black key in between. In that situation, we have a half step between those white keys. So let's identify our half steps in the C major scale with the help of this keyboard. So we have here between C and D, we have full step. Again, full step from the D to the E. Then we have no black key between the E and the F. That's the place where we have a half step. Then again, between F and G, we have whole step to the A, whole step to the B, and then a half step to the next C. And then it repeats itself. In the C major scale, we have between the E and the F, the third and the fourth note, and the seventh and the eighth note, we have a half step. Every other step is a whole step. I can tell you so much, in every major scale, this is the same. So we have always between the third and the fourth notes and the seventh and the eighth note, the half step. But for now, we stay with the C major scale because that is our base where we need to learn the half steps and the whole steps. So the basic problem now, in difference to the piano, is that when we have a C on the piano, it always looks the same. On the violin, the C, one octave lower, can be the third finger on the G string, one octave higher can be the second finger on the A string, and even one octave higher, we already have to go into higher positions on the violin. So the same note on the violin in a different octave can look totally different. On the violin, a half step is basically when we put the fingers really close together. Sometimes when you have very small fingers, there can be a little bit of air between the fingers, but usually I would say a half step is when the fingers are close together. A whole step in the first position on the violin is basically when we have a big distance between the fingers. The exact distance of a whole step and a half step on the violin is determined by the size of your hand and your violin. A whole step between the fingers would look like this. And a half step would look like this. So as we know now, in the natural scale, without any accidentals, we have a half step between the E and the F and the B and the C. Now let me really quickly explain to you how our note system works and where the notes are placed. So basically, there are two positions where the notes can be. One is the space between the lines and one is on top of a line. So between this and this note, there's one step. So this is the A and this is the B, for example. Now, in the case of the violin or many other instruments as well, we sometimes need ledger lines, which are basically a continuation of our note system. So instead of five lines, we now draw just for that one note ledger lines. For example, our lowest string on the violin has two ledger lines and then the dot of the note head is under that. But the ledger lines basically are a continuation of the five lines and are just there to help us to identify very low and very high notes. With ledger lines, the same principles apply. So there can be a note under the ledger lines and then there can be a note on the ledger line. So when we go here from under the ledger line to on the ledger line, the note is one note higher. So this is a G and this would be an A. This is basically how our note system with the five lines in the G clef functions. Next thing to know is that the violin is tuned in fifths, which means every open string on the violin is five notes apart. So this is the positions of the open strings on the violin. You have to get used to those positions and from there on you can count every other note with the knowledge of the basic scale, the C major scale, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C in mind. So this note here with two ledger lines and under those two ledger lines the note head is the lowest string on the violin, the G. The note which stands below all five ledger lines is the D. And then the note in the second space from the bottom is the A string, so the second highest string. And then we have here in the highest space the E string. This is basically what you should learn in your first or second violin lesson. The open strings sound like this. Open G string, open D string, open A string, and open E string. And from here on, we are going to identify the notes in C major, which are between those open strings and be played with the fingers of the left hand. We have here the first finger on the G string, which looks like this. It is located on a ledger line, so it is one step higher as the G string. We have here between those notes, not the situation that one of those small distances apply, the E and F and the B and C. It doesn't apply, so we have here a whole step, which I will mark with this sign. So we keep in mind that from the G, the open string, to the A is a full step, so we put the finger here with a big distance, which is approximately 1.5 finger, away from the nut. Now, to the next note, where we only need one ledger line and then the dot of the note under that ledger line, we have the note B. Now we are in the distance from the first to the second finger A to B. So this is a big distance because it's not one of the small distances. We put the B, the second finger, also in the big distance of a whole step away from the first finger. Now we come to the third finger on the G string, and here we have the situation that we have the note names B for the second finger and C for the third finger. And here we have a natural half step, which I will mark right here. So this is a small distance between the B and the C. Now from the C to the D, we don't have to think because we can play our open D string. But if we would identify it, it is a whole step. We have a big step between the C and the D. So I will now play it for you. G, A, big distance, also big distance to the B, and now small distance to the C, and now big distance to the D. And then we can compare to our open D string if we arrived correctly. So let's continue on the D string. We have the first finger on the ledger line, and between the D and the first finger should be a big distance. So from the D to the E, there's again a big distance. So the finger is the same as on the G string, in a big distance away from the nut. Now we go to the next note, which is the second finger on the D string, and the name of the note is F. And now our alarm bells should ring, because E and F are in a small distance apart, because there's a half step between E and F. So those fingers we should put close together. So we put our second finger close to the first finger, so that they even can touch each other. So now we come to the third finger on the D string, which is the G. And of course, between the F and the G, we don't have a half step, so we have a whole step. So our third finger and second finger are now in a big step, a whole step away from each other. The same applies for the next step from the G to the A. From the G, the third finger, to the A, the fourth finger, a whole step again, so a big step between the fingers. And that sounds like this. D, whole step to the E, half step to the F, whole step to the G, whole step to the A. And then we can compare with the A string if we want. That should be the same note. Here we can play our open A string and continue further. So now for the A string, there's one thing you can keep in mind. Of course, the note names are different, but the finger position, which we had now on the D string, we can translate now to the A string as well. It's the same in C major as the D string. So from the A to the first finger on the A, the B, we again have a hold step. From the B to the C, the second finger on the A string, we have to be careful to put our fingers close together, because this is a half step. Then from the C to the D, we again have a hold step. From the D to the E, we have also a hold step. And that sounds like this. A, big step to the B, half steps to the C, big step to the D, and big step to the E. And then, of course, we can compare our E to our open E string. Then, when we continue to play on the E string, we have the situation that the E and the F, where the half step is located, are now the open E and the first finger. So we have to play our first finger very close to the open E string. So that means now that this time we put our first finger not far away from the nut, but very close to the nut. So we have the open string, the E, and then the low first finger close to the nut. For the F, then we go to the second finger, the G, which is a hold step, the third finger, which is an A hold step, and the fourth finger, the B, and hold step as well. So we end up in this finger pattern. Between every finger, there's a hold step, but between the open string and the first finger, there's a half step. And this sounds like that. Open string, first finger on the F, then second finger on the G, big step, third finger on the A, big step, and fourth finger on the E, big step. I will link to you in the description some sheet music where I put this C major scale and I note where the distances are whole steps and half steps, so that you can understand where the distances between the fingers in the first position are big and small in C major, which is the basic scale we need to understand so that we can read notes on the violin. I will now play for you the whole C major notes, not C major scale, because I will start from the lowest note on the violin, the G, and end on the highest note in the first position on the E string, the B. Make it easier on the violin, it is sometimes better to think in finger pattern than to think about every half step we have on the violin. Of course, when we read notes, we have to be very careful that we play every half step right. But when we know the music, we should remember our finger pattern to make it easier for us to play fast and not to think about every finger every time we put them down. So regarding the finger pattern in C major, we have on the G string this finger pattern, on the D string this finger pattern, A string, same finger pattern, and E string, the first finger goes low, and all fingers are far apart. Let me really fast explain to you why it is so important in my eyes to know the finger pattern of C major, because this is basically our white keys on the violin. It is not symmetrical like on the piano, but if you know all those white keys on the violin, so to say, you can easier identify when you have sharps, where to put those sharps and where to differ from the white key finger patterns. Of course, when we go into different positions, higher positions on the violin, or even in a half position or something, the finger pattern of C major, of course, change. But what doesn't change is that we always have in the major scale the third and the fourth and the seventh and the eighth notes close together, so with a half step. That is really important to remember that. In a minor scale, it is a little bit more difficult because we have different options regarding if we are in natural minor or if we are in harmonic or melodic minor. But basically in minor scale, we have to look out for the accidentals. So I hope this video was helpful for you. I wanted to put this out there as a beginner lesson video before we actually start playing on the violin, because I think that most of you are self-learners, and for you it is very important to understand sometimes before you start playing on the violin what notes you are playing. This makes it easier later to achieve a higher level of playing, because you really understand what you are doing and not only putting the fingers down like someone told you. So I told you now how to put the fingers down in C major, and also I hope that you did understand why we put the fingers down like we put them down in C major, because we have the half step between the third and the fourth and the seventh and eighth note, which is the E and the F and the B and the C. This is very important to remember. Later I will go also in more detail of reading notes on the violin, because I have there a lot of good tips for you. For example, for the circle of fifths, which we can learn quite easily on the violin, and also the order, the accidentals, the flats and the sharps come and go with different tonalities. I hope you stay tuned. Have fun practicing. Bye bye.